Core quality 3, dreams personify. Personification is a way for the mind to process information that is too extensive for cognitive verbal consciousness. The personified systems are manifestations of an unconscious and practical intelligence. From birth, these systems regulate our behavior and experience. They create groups of networks that develop through relationships with our closest caregivers and later important relations. The personified systems are active in everyday waking life and appear clearly in dreams. Systematic content analysis shows that a dream character's behavior and experiences are strikingly equal to waking persons. They display facial expressions, emotional gestures, and prosody as complex as in waking life. Within dream scenarios, thoughts are generally logical and similar to waking cognition, but thinking about scenarios is usually unrealistic. Both the dream I and other characters have a theory of mind, that is, an ability to conceptualize what takes place within the mind of other characters. Surprisingly, about 3 times as much as in reports from waking life. There are many ways to work with the dream persons. In this presentation, I will highlight the dream person's levels of consciousness and particularly the dream egos. The picture shows a schematic representation of the levels of consciousness related to different areas in the brain. From the brainstem to the emotional brain and further to the networks in the imaginative brain, the American brain researcher Antonio Damasio distinguishes between having an emotion and feeling that you have an emotion. Knowing that you have a feeling is a higher level. Reflecting on a feeling is yet another step up. The lowest level, having an emotion, is on the picture referred to as induction of emotion, which means that the emotion has you, so to speak, and that you act on it without awareness. The state of the mind of the dreaming ego is very much like the state of the mind of the waking ego. Thus, dreams give us an excellent opportunity to evaluate the ego's level of consciousness in the context that the dreams refer to. Liza, a 20-year-old woman in therapy with me, was haunted by nightmares. From 10 to 12 years, she was hospitalized for cancer and treated with chemotherapy. The nightmares were about a dystopic world where she was threatened by monstrous, aggressive animals. The level in these dreams was induction of emotion, that is, without awareness. After 2 years of therapy, Lisa dreamt that she meets a 12-year-old girl who is being haunted by ghosts at night. She consoles the girl. Morning arrives, the light returns, and the ghost disappears. She visualized and contemplated the meeting with the girl and cried softly and deeply for a long time. She said that it was only now that she could allow herself to fully sense the depth of her loneliness and sorrow, knowing that she could come back to ordinary consciousness again. The dream, as well as the session, showed the traumatic process of how having a feeling, knowing a feeling, and reflecting on a feeling on the subjective level coupled with empathy for the 12-year-old girl that could personify Liza's lost and found self. The work with Liza's post-traumatic dream is described in detail in my book, A Guide to the World of Dreams.